Dave here, how are you? Now, I've jumped in a little bit early and I apologize for that. My clocks here aren't talking to each other. My mobile phone told me it was 11 o'clock. The clock on the wall was saying 1 minute to, and the computer here is now saying it's nearly 1 minute to 11. But look, doesn't matter. I will go over time a little bit with today's show. There is so much, I've got to pack it all in. Today is the 16th of December 2018. The reason I say the date is because if you go over to the second channel, you will still be able to go through and listen for a bit, and then Dave will say what date it is. And so you might be able to recall what it was I was talking about on that day. But over there as well, I say archived the date as part of the title, and two, maybe three things that were in the actual show. Okay, what have we got today? Let me get this and I'll start reading. I've been reading a bit of the chat down the side here while I was waiting. I got engrossed with the chat and then I was looking at the phone for some reason, I don't know, a message or something like that. And then it said 11 o'clock, panic stations. Here we go. 2 minutes early, yes. Sorry about that, guys. All right, here we go. So today, two separate giveaways this week. And this is a first for the channel. Win a turned bowl from Hilton Bond. Now, it's Mango Crutch, which, you know, I haven't got the bowl here. Hilton is going to send the bowl out to you directly from his place. But he has sent me a few things. And look at these things that he makes. This is all Australian hardwoods, mortar and pestle. And that is substantial. A tea light holder, he says, for those romantic nights. Camphor laurel bowl, and doesn't it smell magic? Even though it's got a finish on it, you can still smell the camphor. And a bowl he's turned out of Oregon. Now, I am thinking I will take on the challenge and count the growth rings in this. This is very, very, very nice. Apparently, it's from a mast, from a sailing boat that was wrecked near him. So there you go. And I'm keeping batteries in it. What have we got? What else have we got? Okay, the Air Stealth from Trend. Now, you guys know that I've got this guy here, which is my, you know, you may as well say this is a Trend Air Shield Pro. I love this thing, but it is a lot of dollars. And when I had more facial hair than I do at the moment, this was basically the only thing that was going to look after me. I could have jumped up to a 3M product, which was going to be another $1,000 or even more, $2,000 in Australia, I think. Anyway, a lot of money. This one is around, you know, $500, $600 in Australia. This guy here, and I was very pleased to find this. They started stocking it in the store during the week, and I thought, I'll try it on. And I did, and I was so impressed with it. With a goatee, this thing is brilliant. It's not powered, it's not silicone, it doesn't stick to your face, it's got two in valves, and the exhaling goes out down the bottom, which is fantastic. So it's got, you can get HEPA filters for the thing, and also, this is kind of an ad, it's because I'm doing it as a giveaway and I got one myself, I was so impressed with it, so that's why I'm talking about it a lot at the moment. And it's got what's called a P3 filter as well, which is classified as a nuisance filter. So it would be good for someone who is doing welding for fumes, for welding, I presume also for fumes with soldering. It will do organic aerosols, or oil aerosols, I should say. It will not be a gas mask. You cannot use this to filter gases. So it's a P3. Research what a P3 will and will not do, and we are offering up one of these as well. Now, I hope to have the competition. The competition is starting at 11 o'clock, so it's already started. Go down to the bottom where it says show more in the description box there. You'll find how to get to two of the different, competitions. So the bowl, it's not this one. You'll see the picture of the bowl and this one. So they're two separate competitions. Sweepstakes, as I keep saying. And this thing won't fog your glasses up. Okay, so if you're wearing these things, wearing this, it expels that down there, and so it's not blowing up around here. Oh, one of the other things, Vicky's got one that's similar to this, but it's powered, and it's got the standard cartridge on the front, and it works fine, except for she gets a little bit dry in her eye because it does tend to leak around the top here. But this one, because it's not powered, and you're, as you're sucking in, it's wanting to pull the thing back against your face, works great. As I say, the filter's very easy to change. You just switch that out, and there they are. So that is a HEPA filter. And the other ones, the nuisance filters, are in the box there. The price, I think, is around $60. I've put a link down in the description box as well, if you're in the States, if you want to get one. If you're in Australia, Carbotec, go to their, in the competition, I actually give you the link to their page that's got all of their safety gear. And away you go. I'm going to just check down through the text here to see if I've got everything happening correctly and whether I've got candle when I'm in the bath, Dave. Yeah, thanks. Whether we got sound and everything. Obviously, sound is coming through because you wouldn't have picked up on what I was just saying. Hilton, I was in the woodshop making and grain cutting boards, but had to stop, come in and watch the show. Of course you do. Hilton is one of the... well, let's call him a sponsor of the show this week because he's given one of the gifts or one of the giveaways. If you're wanting to get some exposure as well, and I think what you're doing is good, because I won't just do this for anyone, by all means, send me an email at davestantonfans@gmail.com. No AU. All right, let's keep going through. Sweepstake, yes indeed. Hilton, John, now I've got a mental picture of Dave in the bath. I won't go any further with that one. You guys can read everything that's coming up in the text, in the chat, even after the show if you're watching on TV, because I've made the screen split, so it's got three things there. It's got the chat, it's got me prattling on, and down in the bottom, down here, you'll see it's got another one. That's where we're getting ready for the demo that I'm going to go through, actually making a new insert for my table saw. And I'm going to show you how easy it is. I'm going to show you a couple of tips on staying safe while you do it. And I'm going to incorporate using the Stanton bench in that construction. Here we go. Okay, John Hilton, do you have a website to see all of your beautiful work? I don't know if he does, but he pops it on Facebook an awful lot. Dave Rollins, good morning from Canberra. Respects, Wood, was waiting for you before we started. Gary Wilkins, morning Dave from Melbourne. Let's see more thumbs up. Yeah, that's great. As I say, if you do the thumbs up in just below what's happening here, the click the thumb icon up. If you don't like what I'm doing, you know, by all means, you can click it down as well. You know, I'm at the whim of your judgment, I guess. Let me see what else we got. Hilton, no, John, don't have a website. Yeah, in the Facebook, yes. 1896, Michael, thank you for being the bean counter for me, Michael. Respects, Wood, on the iPad today from Peter. Darrell Wells, good. Excellent. Good morning all from Beverly Park for Paul. Renato, hello. John Luke, morning, Dave. Stuart West, a struggle with unpowered dust masks due to COPD, but the trend is superb. Yep. Look, I don't normally jump on and start prattling on about a product just because someone's given me a product. You know, people give me a lot of products, don't get me wrong. This thing, when I put it on, I rang the guy up at the head office at Carbotec in Brisbane, and I said, give me one. I didn't hold back. As soon as I put it on, I said, give me one. These things are fantastic. I can't believe how comfortable they are. And give me one to give away on the show. And they did. You can't just give these to someone and then give it to someone else. Like, they couldn't give this to me for me to pass it on to someone else because it's been, you don't want to catch my bugs. So that's why that's happened. Okay. Reading through a bit more, Govinda and everyone there. Terrific. Now, what's the next thing? So I've talked enough about these guys, and as I said, they do have the second filter. Oh, if you're looking for them in the store, they look like that. That's the box, and it comes in two sizes, and I'll show you the difference in the sizes and why they do it. Now, here we go. Here's something that might be interesting. There's the trend mask. I'll flick that over first so you can have a look. And whilst we're doing that, they also have a fitting thing. Now, I don't know if that's on the back or somewhere else, but it's on their website. It's on Carpetech's website. And the thing is to measure from the bridge of your nose to under your chin and the width to the points of your cheekbones. Now, it's not that hard. And so they've got that little grid there. So if you want to, you can look at this grid, or you can go to their website and have a look at the grid. And if you're thinking about getting one, by all means, that's the way to do it. I'll come back to this camera here. So it's very easy. All I do is I just go like that, and then you tape measure there. It's not too hard. Cheekbones, even if you just go to the corner of your eye sockets, outside and transfer down, that's the width. Pretty basic. You know, I don't want to see pictures of people with a tape measure across their face looking like the Lone Ranger, or, you know, it's weird. Anyway, what's the next thing we've got? What's the next thing? Stephen Lee, hello everyone, late to class, straight to the corner, Stephen. Yes, and a note. Itchy nose. What's the next thing? Okay, we're going to make a dado stack. Sorry, we're going to make an insert for a dado blade or a blade or a dado stack. Now, I know in the UK, in Europe, dado blades are illegal, but I think that 6 millimeter or quarter inch flat top blade will fit on your table saw. And if that's the situation, you may want to make an insert. And we'll get stuck into that in about another couple of minutes and do the demo. Also, I'm going to encourage you guys to make comments in the section below where it says, you know, comments. By all means, throw comments in there. Obviously, there've got to be comments that I'm going to review so I can can them or leave them there. And so can the monitors, classroom monitors, they're always good at it. But I encourage you to put those comments in there because that stimulates more conversation about the topic we've been talking about after the show is finished. So the show will get around 500 views during the show, maybe 600 during the show. But it runs for the week and it can run from anywhere to 1,500 people more watch the show after because of their time zone, or it's not convenient to watch an hour-long show at the particular time where I stream. So put comment in down there, and that would, as I say, that will encourage people to learn. And that's what this is all about. This is sharing information. All right. What next? What next? What next? Oh, the winner of the Triton belt sander. And I will announce that person's name a little bit later on today. And I also made a couple of mistakes in the previous stream. What were they? Well, for a start, I said that the gentleman who won the CMT Brad Point drills and the VIX bit actually won the eye-muffs. And I was saying, why don't you put your eye-muffs on and send us a photo? Well, that's impossible because he has some drills. So I'm sorry about that. Also, I made comment when my granddaughter was here, Zoe, the very tall girl, that you double her age when she's two. Well, that's four. You double their height at their second birthday. Now, I also made comment that she was 3'1". My wife reminded me she was 3'2". So she will be 6'4", which is quite a tall lass indeed. Let me see. I'm having little things pop up on this computer down the bottom here that from other things that are happening around the world. And I should really learn how to turn that off while I've got the show running. I'm going to do another bit of a read here. Steve, yes, Doriano, good morning from Wollongong. Really enjoy the streams, Dave. Thank you. Thank you. Stuart West, I'm sure Australia. Aussie bugs are very superior, Dave. Ours are evil little devils. Well, possibly. Daryl, I can't see the comments section on my screen. I have no idea, Daryl, why you can't see that. It's coming up at the moment on everyone else's screen, I think. I think. If you're watching on a TV, Daryl, you may have to watch on a actual computer, and then you can add to it. Respects Wood, that trend looks impressive. My 3M equivalent can only go to P2. It says you need a full face mask to get P3. This is a very impressive little filter. Hilton, I bought one of the Torqueta flat top blades to use it in my Incrobox jig, and it is awesome. Best blade I've used. I can't believe how good it is, Hilton. It's one of those things, as I say, I like to test things first before I tell you guys about it. If I don't like it, I won't tell you about it. If I do like it, I'm straight here and let you know. And it's not a matter of me pushing product. It's a matter of me sharing information of what I like. And if you choose to go and do something about it, totally your call. It's not me shoving a blade down your throat and saying, you must buy this, you know. That's not my game. Okay, Jay Perry, just ordered a Stanton bench this week, can't wait. Okay, let me have a look at that. Now, I'm getting off the subject slightly. The Stanton bench, I'll tell you what, I'm having a ball with it, and Luke is starting to produce in the States, and I will show you a picture of one that's ready to go. He's even on the packing, he's even got it set up so it's Stanton bench, handle with care, and there's the state that he's making them in, which I think is fantastic. I'm so happy that Luke's on board with us. Let me see where I can get back to here, back to the main cam again, and transition back over to there. I keep forgetting to make it go from that screen over to this screen. Gillies, 106 and 49 likes. Well, thank you. Watching on the computer. Well, I don't know what the story is there. Maybe your work has got it so that you can't add to the chat. Maybe there's a block there somewhere, because I know that Daryl tends to sneak a bit of a view when he should actually be working. Live chat is all good. Yep, Dave watching from Ireland. Great stuff as usual. Thanks, Jarlath. That's an interesting name. WI make two, interesting, no comments on mine as well. Derek, you have to enable comments. There you go. Derek's got the answer. He's a wizard. George, greetings, Dave, watching from Atlanta. Love the stream. Dave Crandall, just logged in. Morning, Dave. Bit wet up here in southeast Queensland. It's from the runoff from the cyclone, I guess, that Hilton's been enduring. How'd you go, Hilton, with the cyclone travelling across? I know that it was probably when it hit land at the top of Queensland rather than over in the northern NT, that it probably picked up to Category 3. Okay, you guys, you'll soon have to raise the door frames for Zoe, yeah. Okay, might be the rain in Brisbane, Dave. Okay, I'm going to get stuck into the next demonstration. So let me see what I'm going to move these bowls down here. Oh, look, while I remember, I might even show you, how nice is this? Look at that. Isn't that beautiful work? Now, Hilton actually made that out of four different pieces of timber. You may see that there's a join here down the center, and he's done the same here. He's joined timber to timber there. Now, Hilton, if you want to tell everyone what species they are, go for it. And the hand, the pestle, or is this the mortar and this the pestle? I think that's the way it goes. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much for that, Hilton. One other thing I'll talk to you about before I jump over, and John Lafferty has been making things again. He's a bit of a wizard. He made this. And apart from a bit of blatant advertising, Yellow Box Shed, it is designed to go on the end of a Festool track. Now, this should fit a Festool, Makita, and also a Triton, I think. So there it goes. And how clever. And it doesn't fall off. There's no clamp. You have to actually push quite hard on the end to take it off. Jump into Yellow Box Shed. Links down the bottom into the Surrey area in the description box if you're interested in getting one. These things, I don't know what he charges for them. Festool make them as well, but theirs are a little bit different. I'm looking around the workshop now to see if I can actually see one. I have one of theirs as well. But no, I can't see. All right, let's get stuck into the demo. I'll move these things down here. I'll move the keyboard right out of the way. And this is the part everyone's been waiting for, obviously, isn't it? Are you ready? All right, I'm just going to show some versatility on the Stanton bench as well. I might go to Carl Cam for this one. Carl Cam and chat. There we go. Makes it a bit easier. And aren't the cameras behaving themselves really well at the moment? I've got to switch it over. There we go. The cameras are working extremely well at the moment. Now this is a double dog. So I'm going to use a Japanese style pull saw. Now, this is my folding Japanese saw. I love this thing to bits. It cuts on the pull stroke, not like a Western saw, which is on the push. This one cuts as you pull back. Now, because of that, if I was using a Western saw, I would put that there. But as I'm using a Japanese style saw, I'm putting that there. Now, what am I going to do next? I'm going to move the Stanton bench along a little bit, and you might be interested to see why. I'm going to move it up to about there, and I'm going to slide one of my Craig bench clamps that I've adjusted. Notice I adjust this so that it's got a 5/16 T-bolt, not their dome head bolt, because the dome head bolt will not fit in these tracks. Now this is a Veritas quarter inch T-track, but Veritas quarter inch T-tracks and Rockley Universal tracks will take 5/16 T-bolts. They will not take Festool lever clamps, but they will take a 5/16 T-bolt. And I'll show you how easy. And this is all supplied. When you get a Stanton bench from me, I supply you that, the legs. I don't supply this, but I do supply the Euro screws, which are fantastic. Now what we're going to do is I have a piece of half inch ply here that I've made up from two pieces of quarter inch ply, because I just find that's a little bit more substantial. This is my insert plate for the table saw. Now it's important to know the thickness of the insert plate. And I leave the battery unplugged on this, and I'll go back to zero. Now I'm going to measure from the grub screw, which is a little packing screw, back to the top of the plate. I don't know if you can see that there. You can see the grub screws on the bottom. They're the leveling screws. So I'm zeroed out. I go to zero there. I'm going to measure that. And that is, I don't know if you can read that. It's going to have a hard time with everything down here. There's too many contrasty things down here. But it's saying 13 millimeters, basically, which is very, very close to a half inch. 12.7 millimeters is half an inch. Now, I'm going to put a pencil mark on there. And did I get a pencil out, David? That's the next question. I'll just use a texter. I'm being slack. So this is a Sharpie. I'll put a mark there. Actually, I will trace around that end, and I'm going to trace around the other end, like so. Now, I'll look while I'm there, I'll put the marks in for the finger pulls as well. Done. All right, so we have this marked, and I've used the Sharpie on purpose, basically so that you can see it easier with the camera. All right, first thing I need to do is cut it to length. I'm going to knock it off around about there, because I don't want all of this. I'm going to use this as a, going to pop that there like so. How easy is that? Now, put that out of the way. I'm going to show you one of the features of the bench. Pop that there, that over there. And this is the feature. That Festool sustainer is around 1 millimeter lower than the bench. So now I can use my Japanese saw and cut. With the Japanese saw, don't hold it right at the end. Hold it here and then rest this part back against your hand, and you'll find you've got a whole lot more control. It's an extension of your arm that way. I could have done this on the CapEx, but the whole purpose of the Stanton bench is for people that don't have a garage or any of these fancy tools. Just sit it up on a kitchen table. There you go. Off cut, right here. There's no tearing. Have a look at the back of that. It's a beautiful cut. So, move that out of the way. Now I'm going to pull it along a little bit further. And I'm going to do some other cuts. I'm going to cut it here, and I'm going to cut it here. And it might take a little while, but it's worth it. Nearly through. Done. And swing around. Don't you love it? I haven't got time to read the comments right at the moment, guys, but I will. These little bits, I don't care if they're just falling on the floor. It makes no difference. Now let's pop that up. They get a good grip in here. There we go. Now I want to cut that one. So, how to do that? Just bring that along. And again, we only need to take these bits off for what we're going to do. Okay, and around that way. Doesn't it make it easy? Beautiful. There we go. I've got my blank now that I'm ready to take to the router table. I'm going to do a bit of a read. Push that over there. And I've got a camera set up over there right on the table so we can see what's happening. Move that back over here. I love it. Fold that guy up. One of the things about working in a workshop, you try and keep things tidy and put away, and then you're not going to stumble over anything. I'll go back to this other camera over here and switch back. Okay, gonna have a quick read. Get that back on the website. Massive storms and you dump so much rain. John Lefty, I hope your days are getting better. Health is stable. Yes, Russ, all right. Hi everyone. Long time to me. Long time no me. Finally freed up some time to watch tonight. Well, welcome, Russ. It's good to see people coming back. Good to hear you doing better, John. Stuart West, that's good news, John. John, how do you highlight someone's name? I'm not sure. If you want to, maybe just put at or the hash sign in front of their name. See how that goes. Type an at before their name. Okay, there you go. John Larry, do you mean with the spanner? No, at John Lafferty, thanks for the bench dog set. They are great. Try not to put a space between Lafferty. That might work. It's not working on the chat, is it? Russ, John Power's guide system dust collection board is absolutely brilliant. Yes, it is. It is. Hilton, the mortar is made from local hardwood. I believe they were stringy bark and black wattle. And the pestle is made from mangrove. Terrific. Terrific. Okay, next thing to do is I'm going to swing the camera over there. And I'm going to swing this other one around. This is going to be a little bit of mucking around, but I think we should be okay. Transition to there. Here we go. I'm going to move around here, and that other camera, as I say, will be looking around there. I'm going to try and spin this around without dropping the monitor off the bench. Now, you may notice if you watch Instagram that I picked up a monitor Let's see if I can get that right over there so I can see what's happening. I picked up a new monitor yesterday from Aldi. Now, I'm not promoting it at all, but when I walked past it, I thought, you've got to be kidding me. I can't believe the price they're selling these things for. It's a 4K. I'm going to switch this back over here. There we go. It's a 4K monitor. It's 50 inch. What would you expect to pay? Well, basically, it's a TV, but you can use it as a monitor. But at 4K, which is, you know, full ultra HD, $399, brand new. I couldn't believe it. I'm going to switch this over to there. So there we go. I'm back in the show again. All right. Yeah, $399. I said to Vicky, I can't walk past that and not take it home. Because it will make working with Vectrex Aspire program or VCarve, whichever, or any small CAD program, just so much more real estate for me to be able to see what's happening here, because you're consistently dragging stuff around on the screen large enough for you to be able to see, and also you want to be able to see what it's how it's affecting other parts of the project you're working on. So this is going to be fantastic. That's going to be my fun afternoon this afternoon, unwrapping that Christmas present and getting it running. So what we have here now is the insert, and I'm going to get some tape. Now this stuff is called Turner's tape that I'm going to be using. And Turner's tape is great, but it's also a little bit hard to work with. Now it is super, super duper sticky. I might go to the other camera again, which is this one. There we go. So we've got, this is my insert plate from the saw over here. And this is the blank that I'm working on. I'll put the specs on so I can see what's happening. Turner's tape is this stuff. As I say, I put it on here because I want to use this on my router table here to use this as my pattern to shape this perfectly. Now, it may or may not work for some people. Take it to about there. Depending on how good the insert for your saw is already. Now this is the hard part. This is the very, very hard part. This stuff is almost impossible to pull up from the corner. So I scratch a hole through the surface back from the corner. And sometimes if you're lucky, you can get enough of the meat to be able, it depends on your fingernails, to be able to lift it. There, I got it. There you go. That's how I do it. It takes forever. It's almost impossible to peel it up on the corner, because what happens is the corner comes up at the same time. So we're going to do it one more time. I'll do it back a little. Scratch through the surface until you get enough pulled up to get a grip on. There we go. I've got enough there. I'm going to hold that one while I go down the other way. And I'm going to come back this way, work around the waist. Got it. There you go. That, my friends, is a tip for you guys that has cost you nothing. Cost you nothing at all for that tip. And it's a bloody good tip. Okay. Now, I'm going to bond that to that, but I've already ripped this to the correct width. So how I'm going to do it is I'm going to sit it up on the table, side by side, both of them pushing down, and I'm going to make sure that they're aligned, and then push them together like so. And push down on it. Okay. I'll go back to the other camera so you can see what's happening there. Transition. Now I have that bonded and away you go. I'm going to read a little bit of the chat. Give me a second. I'm too far away. I am too far away. Ken, your Christmas gift was doing some shopping spree at Bunnings, Ryobi Tools. Excellent. John Lafferty, Julie has given me some really good double-sided tape from a paper craft supply. Works great on wood for this type of job. Brilliant tip, that's fine. Anyway, there's probably a whole lot more chat there. You guys can read it down the side. But that's what I use and why I use it. Now, I'm going to show you a picture of what I'm about to do. See, just here on my table, my router table's insert, there is a little spot there. And that is for a brass pin to go in. I'm going to show you a picture of what it is. There it is. Now, I use that to act as my pivot point for when I am bringing stuff up to the router, so it doesn't get caught and flicked behind. So I'm going to go to this one, then I'm going to try and go to the one where I'm up close again, which is there. Now, I'll grab the out of the drawer here. I've got a few things that I'm going to do. I've already got the right cutter in there. I'll get the pin. This is the pin I was talking about. So if you get a router table and this comes along and you don't know what the hell it's for, that's what it's for. There we go. These things work brilliantly. And then I'm going to raise the cutter up. And now the other thing is, I cannot turn my router table on if that is not in the switch. This is a switch, mechanical immobilizer for the switch on the table. So I'm going to open up down under here. You guys can watch what's happening from over there as well if you need to. And I'm going to raise this cutter up just enough so that the bearings are still going to be making contact with... I'm raising it up very, very slowly using the fine adjust. I could use the crank down through the top here, but for the moment, I'm going to take it up until we've got the cutter actually there. Now, I'm going to lock it at that height. When I find the spanner, it'll be in here. No, it's not. Let me see. Have I got that spanner or is it another one? I think it's that one. Give me a second. There it is. It was hiding underneath. That's the spanner. It's a 12 mil spanner that I use to tighten up the router in position. So with any router, they tend to vibrate a little bit, and that cutter would slowly work down if you don't lock the body at the right height. Now, you can see here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to present this to the cutter, but I'm actually going to present it around about there. Actually, what I'll do is I'll present it back here and it'll slowly come in. Now, I don't want it to grab. This is going to help me stopping it from grabbing and flicking and pulling my hand in there. This is very, very important. Now, I was thinking about turning the dust extraction on as well. And you know what? I've got a bit of time. Let's do that. It's all well and good to talk about safety, but then, you know, if you don't do it, that's another story, isn't it? People call you a hypocrite. So this guy comes out and it's my saddle for my router table that goes on to the table saw. I'll flick camera so you can watch what I'm doing. Switch it back over again to the main and transition. Okay. You've probably seen on other videos where I've used this guy here. This is a saddle that goes on top of my table saw's fence, which I've just brought into line here. and I'm going to pop that on top there. Push it back a little bit before I lock it down. It's got mag switches at the front and at the back. And it's got fences there. And I'm going to bring it up. So it's going to lock in position there. I'll put the dust port on the back and come around to your side. Now the fence is the thing that's going to, it's the actual dust port. So I'm going to loosen these off. Maybe if I switch that again, back to the other camera again. So you can see what's happening from here. I'm going to undo these three screws or just back them off a little bit. I can open that up and that's a nice gate to catch everything there. Again, this is only going to be used as a dust collection port. And I'll open that one up just a little bit. About there. Now, underneath the table, the cabinet that this is mounted in also has a dust collection port under there. So it's going to pull from here and also underneath. It's a spiral up cutter, which means it cuts up towards the router itself. It's not going to be cutting up this direction because the router is inverted, it's upside down. So it's going to be, it's in a way, it's a spiral down cut. Don't ever use a router cutter that has the bearing at the bottom and follow a template that's up that way. So don't ever do it this way up and have the router at the bottom, or sorry, the bearing at the bottom and the cutter up this way. You have a whole lot of blade exposed to you, and that is extremely dangerous. I have the bearing exposed to me at the top here, which is a whole lot safer than the other way around. The other way is if you're using a router in your hand and you're tracking around, well, that's fine. That's the way to do that. But in a router table, always use the one with the bearing at the top here. Now I'm going to do a couple of things. I'm going to follow along there, and then I'm going to follow along there to make sure that it's got it all. And I'm going to use my push blocks to do that as well. And I will also wear, I'm going to do it all. Let me switch back to the main camera, which is this bad boy here. And I'll get the stealth and I'll wear the earmuffs. The air stealth. It sounds really military, like commando. All right, and of course this is for the dust extraction. I'll make sure that port down there is shut, which it wasn't. Close that. Well, that's one thing I should really look at researching is these automatic dust ports. But, you know, I don't know. I'll open a pair of those and I'll make sure that this one under here is shut. Yep. That's all looking pretty good. I will turn the dusty on now to just check. Yep, that's sucking there. And down through there. I don't think anything else is turned on. Turn it off again. Push blocks, very important. And personal protection. This one on first.
It's got these little clips that just hook over each other. And you can pull them tight from behind your head if you need to, which I have just done. Stick them up. Okay, so we got that. I'll put the earmuffs on at the same time, and hopefully I don't start talking too loud. With the earmuffs, I found put them back all the way to start, put them on, and then slowly pull it back. Just move my specs. There we go. I'm already set go, and I'll plug that into the router, and I'll test that the router is working. Yes, it is. I'll turn it off. I'll turn the dust on first. It's running. I'll switch the screens around again. There you go. As I said, I'm going to go along here first. Careful.
Beautiful. Look at that. Nothing fogged on those specs. Absolutely fantastic. I got a really, really nice result on all of the turns. I didn't feel nervous at all about any of them. The cut is magic. That little thing from the bearing, don't worry about that. There we go. We've got a beautiful result. Now I'm going to take the monitor back to the bench. So we'll leave it there for the second. I will. I'm just thinking aloud as I'm going. I'll spin this around so it's kind of looking back there properly where we were. And this, and we swing this back around to there, to there. Okay, there we go. That is what we have. And that only took a couple of minutes. What do you reckon? So that's what that little pin's for on a router table. It makes things extremely safe. I'm going to have a quick read. Where are we? Dave, Ron Polk has a lot of trouble with bearing following bits and has thrown them out. Could you do this with a template router, but you have to calculate the offset? Yeah, could do, but I've never had a problem with these bits. That one is it's a twin bearing, and it does a beautiful job. And it's a spiral up. Use it. It's great. Saw that Ron was not happy with the bearing. Well, you know, maybe Ron's not using the right colors. That's a really nice cutter. I think it's a CMT. It does a very, very nice job. You saw how good it was. Like, there's no trick. You saw me do that. And it does a magic job. It all depends on how fast you're going, what you're cutting, and, you know, just keeping your wits about you. Ron's a smart fella, don't get me wrong. I'm surprised. I haven't seen that one, that episode of Ron's throwing a nut, going nutso at a bearing. Okay. let me see, Frank C. Woodworking General, what router do you have? It's a Triton. It's the 3 1/4 horse Triton that's mounted under the bench. Not a problem. Matthew D., I have a template bearing disintegrate recently, but I'm putting that down to age and heat. I will know better for the next time for a new way to get it done. Jack Coates, hola. Hola. Is that Spanish? I'm not sure. Respects Wood, time to sand the edges with the Triton belt sander. Oh, yeah. Not going to happen, though, on this episode. John Luke, can the flat top blade be machined to 30 millimeter arbor? I doubt it. A lot of the times, those arbors in table saws are knockouts. You can knock them out and put different ones in. You can put a 30 and a 5/8, depending on what saw it is. Research that. It might help. Now, the next thing I have to do is actually get that off there, and it's not hard. It's just a matter of the wide chisel. Push that down. And my mallet, which is over there. This show's been going along quite well. I'm quite happy with it, guys. What do you reckon? Pop that there on the old Stanton bench, did I mention? All right, I'm going to turn it around this way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to favor with my chisel. I'm going to put the flat side against the timber. The bevel side I'm going to put against the steel, because then it won't dig into it. There we go. Gotcha. And there is my brand new insert. Now I'm going to drill a couple of holes in it. I've still got 10 minutes left. I have the tape on here, which I can, if I want to, I can peel it off now. Or there's enough stick there. To do it again. Look. So use this, but don't rush into things. Just do things slowly. I could cut up another piece of this and have a second blank. All right, let's go over to the drill press and knock a couple of holes in this. Won't take me long. I'll whip this out of here. I'm sorry I haven't got a camera set up close to this for you to watch. I'll do this with what size is this? It is a 1 inch. I'm going the wrong way, of course, you idiot. Got a magnet up the top there, which helps a lot. Let me see what speed have I got set there. That's not a very fast speed. Maybe I should kick the speed up a little bit more. Yep. Now look, I'm gonna leave it at a slow speed. It's not gonna be the cleanest of cuts, but it's gonna do the job. I'll check that I've got close enough to the center of the hole there, which I have. I'll just put the one hole in it today. We'll leave that go. So now I've got a finger pull so I can get it out. Let me have a quick read. Greg, have you heard of anyone in Oz bringing in the throat plates with replaceable inserts for the SawStop PC? Yes, you can. You can get them from Carbotech. They've got the dado insert, and for the professional, for the industrial, and the contractor. The other one, I don't know if they've got any. They probably could get the dado insert for the job site. But yeah, they've got them. They've got them. You just bring the blade up through at whatever thickness. Darren, all good, Dave. Excellent. Peter, another success. Stephen, you're enjoying the show. That's great. 121 and only 12 likes. Are you kidding me? There's got to be more likes than that. It just placed an order with you from Steve. Excellent. Gillies, did I say, yeah, 65 likes. I thought it might have been more than that. Are you drinking? What are you drinking there, Peter? refresh the screen. Indeed. All right. Okay. I have to go. Thanks for the show, Dave. All you all keeps it. Thanks, Wayne. Thanks for watching. All right. Let's spin this camera around and see if it actually fits in the table saw. So this is where you all hold on while I spin the camera around while you're watching. And get that off there. And I think that's about right. And I will move this one over here and see if I can aim it to about there. Get the mouse and bring it back over. Look, I've gone all of this show without having a drink of anything. And normally I grab a little bit of something to keep my throat from drying out. Okay, here's the old one. As I say, I make them and I put those little guys, rare earth magnets, in there. And this one has got all sorts of stuff for the standard blade, which when it's swinging over at 45 degrees, needs all these holes and this contraption here to be able to allow the nut on the trunnion to come up. But this dado's, I don't swing a dado at all. So let's see how this goes. What do you think of that, guys? I love it. That's just beautiful. There's no movement. There is no movement on that at all. It could be slightly thinner. So I could put that, and there's to lift it up out of the way, or I think it might even go that way, because it's always good to have these finger holes away from the blade. See, the blade is on this side. That's the flat top blade. I haven't taken it out because I haven't done any work here for a couple of days. So have the holes opposing on the other side. And I'll put a hole there, and that one's already got the hole there. And as I say, I'll put some magnets in it. I might give it one pass through the thicknesser on the underside, maybe a millimeter. And I think that'd be lovely. That's beautiful. How nice is that? That's so easy to do. I have not tried making the insert with the CNC. I'm reading down directly below what's happening here. Yeah, respects for the trend mask must have prevented the dehydration. Just like I bought one. Indeed it is, Gary. John Parra, perfect fit. Well done, Daryl. Looks good. Yep. It's great fun. All right, I'm going to swing this back again. This time, while we've got the camera at the other side. And we need to say who won the belt sander. I guess that's why everyone's hanging around. Oh dear. Now, as I said, I'm going to try to switch this over to start there and there. Before I get into that, Mike Campbell, howdy from where? From Tennessee. You're a little bit late, Mike. Off to the corner, you know. Go and sit in the corner until it's time to come out. Now, you'll only be there a short while, buddy. Okay. What do we got? Take that off. I love this bench. I love it. I love it. You want one? Flick me an email. Here's the one for the Stanton Bench. dave@stantonbench.com.au. There you go. That's the one. And we're getting a website built. It won't be long before it's finished. Will it, John? And we'll get that sorted. And at the moment, that if you just punch in www.stantonbench.com.au, it will go to my Etsy site. Now, we will be transferring that as soon as the website's finished. It will be going, that domain name will be going straight to my new website, which John's wife, Julia, is very kindly creating for us. And she's been under the pump with things at work, end of the year, and she's been staying up late. And labor of love. So thank you very much for this, Julia. You're a champ. And John, I know, has had the whip out. Hold on, I've just got a vision. Let's back up from that one. Anyway, you guys are doing terrific stuff to helping me out with that. John has also been saying, Dave, why don't you do a video on what bench dogs are for? And I can, of course. But give me time. Now, there was some. I need to have a quick read down the side here because I think there's some other pictures there that I wanted to show you. Oh, yeah, there's a picture here. The other day I had to, I've changed the dust extraction for the CNC. I've put the one horse machine outside. Now still undercover, but because the CNC generates so much dust and the pickup from the brush and everything is not as good as it could be, there was a bit of a haze developing in the air. I thought, you know, this is going to kill me. I've put the machine outside, and it's a huge thing. So I had to buy some fittings the other day. So let me see if I can show you this. This is the local hardware store near my place up at Lawson. How cool is that? This is old. You walk in there and you half expect to see the sign saying Cunningham's Hardware, and you see Howard Cunningham and Richie and Fonzie and all the gang rock in. It's another world. I love it. Okay, so you're quivering with excitement. Are you there, Ian? Well, you stop quivering, buddy, because you did not win it. Okay, I'm going to read some of the things out for it. We're nearly at time. You know, there's pages of entries. Like, huge. Well, you saw how many entries there were. And people can enter a few times a day. Oh, sorry, every day you can put another entry in if you want to. And I've done the same with the Air Stealth and also with Hilton's beautiful Mango Bowl. Let me see here. Ian Capes, I've always wanted a Super Jaws as a second pair of hands. These are things that, you know, people have said. Derek Lark, 500 watt geared head sander is what he'd like. Greg Burchell, the Triton belt sander, which is the one that we're giving away. Stuart, an oscillating spindle sander. Paul Mumford, the 450 watt oscillating spindle and belt sander. That's not actually available in Australia at the moment, so maybe you're looking on the England site. John Trapano, the 2400 watt dual mode precision plunge router, and that's the one that I've got in that router table, and isn't it a cracker? Let me see. Nicola Walsh, I'm sorry, I don't pronounce your name correctly. Any tool would be used in my workshop. Good idea, Nicola. Josh, the rider guide rail adapter, and that's something I was looking at as well, because Triton and Festool's tracks are almost identical, and if their follower was going to run on that, I was thinking about buying one of their followers to put on a smaller, you know, maybe the 1100 or the 1010 router that Triton sell. That could be good. Steve Bruford, the belt sander would be a great addition to our men's shed, as we don't have one and need one desperately to help with our community projects. You know what? Why don't you put it to Triton? Because I'll tell you now, Steve, you didn't win. But you could approach them. Of course, I'm sure I can't speak on their behalf that they would give you one. But if you don't ask, I've found in this world, if you don't ask, you will not get. It's as simple as that. John Granote, the palm belt sander. And that's something I'm getting. I'm going to get that little palm belt sander. David, the TPL 180 1500 watt triple blade planer, 180 millimeters. And that is another tool that I'm getting. The capacity on that plane is only 1 inch narrower than my jointer, the big aircraft carrier thing over there. Doriano Matic, 1400 watt plunge track saw. That's a nice tool as well. There's heaps here. I've highlighted a few. Derek Lark, another, it's gone for a second go. Either of the orbital sanders would be most welcome in my shop. Ian Carey, all of them. Well, yeah, but none of them, Ian, I told you. Deb Scott, oscillating multi-tool. I could have given it to my knee surgeon. So poor old Deb had a knee replacement a little while ago, and she had another one last week. I'm hoping you're doing well in hospital there, Deb, and you get out of there as soon as you can. And Matthew, the router adapter plate and set of rails with a sustainer, please. I don't want to be greedy. I don't know why Triton in Australia don't have any of the sustainers. I'm curious, because that was one of the big things when I first started looking at Triton. I thought it'd be great to have Festool sustainers down one side of the drop saw and Triton on the other, but it wasn't an option quite at the moment. Maybe they will, you never can tell. All right, here we go. Drum roll, we're 5 past. We need to hurry it up. So the winner from last week. Did I tell you the story? Okay, I'm gonna put you all out of your misery. It is Alan Atkins. Alan, you're the guy that's won this beautiful sander. I'll get it down so you can all see it again to refresh your memory. And it is a lovely sander. This machine, I've used it a fair bit now, and I'm very happy with the machine I had prior to this, which I just threw out, as a matter of fact. I've had it for 30 years, and it's an old Makita 3-inch belt sander. And the reason I'm getting rid of it, it did not have dust extraction. This guy does have a dust port right here. A little bit of mucking around to connect my Festool to it, but I can. But it's designed for the Triton dust hose. And why wouldn't they? It's their machine. Love it. It's a great machine. All right. Thank you very much, everyone, for watching. And I'm going to read out the name of my patrons that helped me do this silly show. And let me bring tips on how to do things if you are only new at doing woodwork and you've bought a couple of machines and you're a little bit concerned that you might damage yourself. Please keep watching, because I try and cover things for advanced and also for beginners. I try and help out as much as I can. So we've got Chris Sullivan, Roger DeBolt, Johannes Mauer, John Wilson, John Parra, Vincent Nyang, Andrew Havriliv, John Lafferty, and Peter Woolworth. Thank you so much. These are all people that help support the show, and actually everyone who supports me in Patreon. The money goes towards keeping this show going. So thank you again, everyone, so much for doing that for me. So you're doing that for me, and I can give back via the show. All right, let me see what time it is. I'm going to have a quick read. Dennis Bushby, g'day, Dave, Tim. Those are the best and the people they're working. Whoops, you're going through so fast. Well done, Alan. Yeah, everyone loves Alan. Alan's your best mate. You're going to go around and borrow his machine when he gets it. Alan, you need to get that email, your address to me as quickly as possible, even before I send out the email saying that you won. You need to get it to me so I can get it to Triton tomorrow morning and they can get it out the door quickly, because it's coming up to Christmas. I want this in your workshop, not this one, but one in a brand new one in a box in your workshop for Christmas Day. And it was only a short week this week. Thanks, another great show, Dave, from Doriano. Ken, have the great Christmas, everyone. Keep safe. Yes, Russell, all right, great show, Dave. Thank you, Hilton. Thank you. What's the blue bench dog's knobs for? I don't know if I'll tell you. they're a clamp. They're a clamp for holding this down on the CNC. I'm going to put insert nuts in the spoil board in set positions. You know I've smashed screws before. I don't want to do it anymore. That's why I've got John to make these. They're a low profile clamp that I'll just screw down through a dog hole into an insert. It will position the sheet in the perfect position on the bench, and then away I go. And no screws, nothing to smash, because it's all plastic up the top. That's what they're for. Yes, the blue knot, there you go, all done. Okay, I come out of the corner. Mike, by all means, you can come out of the corner, get your coat and hat and down to the bus stop and wait to go home. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'm going to see if I can get this where we are here, where everyone is supporting me, and a little intro, outro. And thank you, everyone, for coming. Look after yourselves, stay safe, be nice to each other, and I shall see you next week, the Christmas special.